How's it going, everyone? Badger here. We got a story coming out of Bounding Into Comics that I think I know what this is actually about, but let's read it first. We'll talk about it at the end. Before we do, I don't know about you, but when I'm watching a Godzilla movie or any of these MonsterVerse movies, every time it goes to the human perspective, it comes to a screeching halt because they're just uninteresting characters. I get that the humans are supposed to be the point of view characters, but most of the time, with like the exception of Charles Dance and the first Godzilla, 2014 Godzilla, I just don't care about the human story. I want to see monsters fight each other. Let's see what this article says. Monster Legacy of Monsters, EP and director Matt Shakman disagrees that the monster versus humans are lackluster. Okay, let's see why. Let's see why we're wrong and he's right. A common criticism of Legendary Pictures' MonsterVerse is it lacks strong and memorable human characters. Oh, you didn't think Ice Cube's son was good? Indeed, they rarely measure up to Bryan Cranston's performance in Gareth Edwards' 2014 Godzilla film, which some might say he overacted in that. Some might. And the kaiju routinely upstage them. Yeah. That is honestly what viewers would rather see, ourselves included. Monsters brought to life with cutting-edge visual effects, tearing stuff up in a tooth-and-claw slugfest. The good news on that front is Legendary and Godzilla X Kong, the new Empire's director, Adam Wingard, answered the call and will supposedly give us more monster action than ever in the upcoming sequel. Yeah, but you're also bringing back Millie Bobby Brown and the dude playing podcast and the guy from Deadpool 2, the kid. I'm not going to learn their actual character names because I don't remember them. That takes care of that. But this development might not improve the lot of our human protagonists. It might even be detrimental to what are seen as thin characterizations already on thinner ice. Yes, thin as F. Most of the people populating the MonsterVerse are connected to Monarch in some way, which has deeper roots than anyone imagined a decade ago. Apple TV series Monarch, Legacy of Monsters, which Chris Gore says is boring AF, I've seen like 4 or 5 episodes, is picking up the slack and adding depth to the individuals and families on the grid. So just what everyone wanted none of. When they're already complaining, they just wanted monsters. Here's a TV series with less monsters in it and more humans. Even though it does have an impressive cast, Kurt and Wyatt Russell, Kiersey Clemons, and Nanny Sawai. It also has a noteworthy executive producer, Matt Shakman. Okay, so this is the impetus for this, who directed the first 2 episodes. Discussing film, asked him about the human characters in the shared universe he now has a hand in. And Shakman begs to differ with all the harsh critics of their potency in the story. I don't share that opinion clearly about the MonsterVerse movies, he said. The executive producer pointed to ensemble casts the MonsterVerse is used to by now. I mean, if you just think about, and by the way, yeah, because I guess we don't, if you want to include Skull Island, which I guess is include, yeah, that had a good ensemble cast, but you set that up as first of all, that's Kong, not Godzilla. And yeah, you had Sam Jackson and Tom Hiddleston. And oddly enough, Brie Larson, who's very likable in it. And you forget, it's almost like when she's chosen for the right role, she's completely capable of being charming. These are incredible characters in that movie. Yeah, but that's not what people are complaining about. They're complaining about the Godzilla movies. They're very memorable. Yeah, they are. He points to the one example, not the 3 or 4 examples everyone is talking about. Earlier in the interview, Shakman expressed his admiration for Legendary series and shared his Goji fan bona fides. I'm a big fan. I love the movies. Love Gareth's Godzilla. Love Kong Skull Island. I think that's a tremendously... Yeah. You know, what this ultimately just smells of, though, is everyone is praising the human characters in Godzilla Minus One. That some people are forgetting it's a Godzilla movie during the acting parts in the story, that they're such good characters, such good story, and that it's so beautifully wrapped up with the Godzilla attack story that it's putting all of these to shame. And yeah, this sounds like a defensive, why are you like human characters in their movie but not mine? Because they were actually characters, and yours are thin veneers of characters. Well, do you like the human characters in Godzilla movies? Did you hate them, but for some reason you like them in Godzilla Minus One? Let me know in the comments. Let me know what you think of this. Have a good one. We'll see you later.